let me give you some practical tips on how you can, at the practical level, express your love or your liking to yourself. First one, as I keep telling you about any relationship, is communication. You have a loved one, you communicate a lot. When you have initially fallen in love, you communicate so much that the other person gets fed up. You send 100 I love you messages and the other person gets absolutely fed up of you. And I even ask people, youngster who is just falling in love and is going on saying I love you to the partner. I say that, is your partner mentally retarded? Unless you say so 100 times in a day, he or she will not understand what you are saying. That's what we do with slow learners and all that. Go on repeating the lesson till the lesson goes in or something of that sort. But how do you communicate with yourself? Are you comfortable talking to yourself? Can you sit alone and carry out a nice, pleasant conversation with yourself? At the end of the day, when you are going to sleep, can you have a nice communication with yourself? When you wake up in the morning, can you have a nice communication with yourself? It can be done. It's just a question of habit. If you develop the habit of communicating to yourself, the same way as we make a conscious effort, no? Oh, I've got a child who has become an adolescent, so I need to ensure that the communication is good. So I go out of the way to be nice to that person, whoever it may be. A new neighbor has come in, let me make friends so that we have a harmonious neighborhood and this and that. So I go out of the way to communicate, I'll talk to that person, things of that sort. Which also brings me to the other aspect of spending quality time with yourself. You like to do window shopping. It doesn't cost anything, it doesn't hurt anybody, it is not illegal, unethical, nothing of that sort. How stupid to go alone and do window shopping. Now when I go with a friend, the friend's tastes are different. And I want to look at this shop and he wants to look at that shop, with the result that nothing happens. Now if I say I deserve quality time with myself, I like this particular flavor of ice cream which is only in Corner House, so I will go to Corner House, sit alone and happily take 10-15 minutes to eat that bowl of ice cream and thoroughly enjoy it. It's nothing big pinch of your pocket. Again, you're not indulging in anything else, but you are spending quality time with yourself. The third area is when you want to build a good relationship, you have to bring in some amount of affection and caring. Do you express that affection? Do you show that little caring to yourself? Normally, I like to save money, so I don't go by auto, I will go by bus. It costs much less than an auto. Today, I am very tired and it's a very hot day. I have spent 4-5 hours outside. Can I be caring to myself and say, it's okay, I'll spend $100 extra today. I will catch an auto and go. Only to be affectionate, sensitive and caring to myself, the same as you would do to somebody. Let's say your mother had come with you and both of you traveled by bus. After going to 3-4 places, it's a very hot afternoon, and you know that your mother needs to get back home and she's getting old or whatever it is. What would you do? Even though you know you cannot normally afford that 100-200 rupees extra, you would say, oh, it's perfectly okay. Once in a while, it's worth it. I care for you enough that I don't want you to be waiting for the bus half an hour in the afternoon, so come, let's take an auto and go. Can you do that same thing to your own self? And can you back up this by actually words of affirmation? I always tell no that it is not enough to love somebody, you also have to tell somebody that you love him. Which is something which I keep pointing out. We don't even have it in our mother tongues. Most of us do not know the equivalent of I love you in our mother tongue. Even if we know it theoretically, we never use it. It's that bad. But for every close relationship, every person in this world whom you love, you need to actually say so. You may be doing it in so many other ways, but you still need to say it verbally. And the same thing applies to your own self. When was the last time that any one of you said, I love you to yourself? Then, why you are not a lovable person at all? Never felt like a stupid person I am in the question of being a... You do it, congrats. Hearty congrats. Fantastic.
I try to listen to the affirmations by Louise Hay. And she says the first thing you look at yourself in the mirror now and then. Exactly. But frankly, I've been trying from quite a few days to truly feel it and say it to oneself. That means you have to work backwards. There's something which is holding you back.
I told you my daily examples like forgiveness, for example, something that I have done like this, or something that I don't appreciate, somewhere where I am comparing myself. So the moment I look in the mirror, I start saying, oh, my sister is much more good looking than me, or something of that sort. It happens at the subconscious level, we don't even realize it. But that is what plays a very significant role. So I want you to understand that and work on this thing of actually doing it. It could be standing in front of the mirror and saying I love you or I appreciate you or you are a very nice person or whatever it is. It could be writing a note to yourself. It could be in 100 different ways. You choose and have as much variety as possible. And last but not the least, a very, very neglected area of relationships, and that is touch. In our Oriental and our third world culture, touch unfortunately has only two extremes. Either it is going and touching the feet of your grandmother. So you have to do it whether you like it or not. Grandmother's feet may be dirty, smelly, but you have no choice. So what do? Very conveniently, when we go there, we go to the grandmother, show our respect by going there, and our fingers are 3 inches away from her foot, and we come back and we say, okay, I have done it. But if you really love your grandma, and she is whatever 80, 90 years old, she is suffering from whatever various old age ailments, she doesn't keep good health, and she is very weak. She doesn't need anybody to come and touch her feet. What does she need, tell me? She needs a nice, warm, bare hug. But do we do that? Look at this youngster. Shameless going and no respect for the grandmother. That sort of thing. Either it is this, or it is looked upon with sexual innuendos. That touch is to do with romance or sex or something of that sort. But touch has such wide avenues which are neither at this end where you forcibly have to touch, or in formal occasions you are supposed to shake hands whether you like it or not. Many a time I hate shaking hands with totally unknown person just because he is being introduced to me and he is some big shot or something of that sort. I don't like it, but I have to do it. On the other hand, I may meet somebody. Let's say I meet a friend of mine after a long time. My spontaneous reaction would be to probably put my arm around him. But is it the accepted thing? Particularly if we are not youngsters or teenagers or whatever it is. When we were 20 years old, probably if I had done it, he would have appreciated it. But today if I do it, I have to be careful. What will he think? you know, will he appreciate it? Now, why am I saying this? Because we need to touch ourselves. There's a skin hunger, which many of us don't realize. Whenever you find yourself uncomfortable in some company, what do? You sit like this. Whenever you feel a little tired or need for something, you sit like this. I can go on reading examples of how we show our need for our own touch. But most of the time we do it subconsciously. Do it consciously. Say, I need my own touch.
All is well.
All is well, yes. Yes, absolutely. I think that is a wonderful way to end today's session by saying, all is well. And I thank you all. And please go out and love yourself.